miscellaneous exercise on chapter 8. Find the area under the given curves and given lines. Y is equal to x square, comma, x is equal to 1, x is equal to 2 and x axis. So, which is directly integration of x is equal to 1 to x is equal to 2, y is equal to f of x form x square dx, which is nothing but x cube divided by 3, and the limits are from 1 to 2. So, we will get 8 by 3 minus 1 by 3, 7 by 3 square units. Now, second problem, y is equal to x power 4, x is equal to 1 and x is equal to 5 and x axis. So, which is integration of x is equal to 1 to x is equal to 5, x to the power 4 dx, which is x power 5 by 5, and the limits are from 1 to 5. So, which will give 5 to the power of 5. So, 1 5 will get cancelled. 5 to the power of 4 minus 1 by 5. 5 power 4 is 625 minus 1 by 5. So, which is equals to 3124 divided by 5 square units. Second problem, find the area between the curves y is equal to x and y is equals to x square. So, y is equal to x is a upward parabola. Y is equal to x, sorry, y is equal to x square is the upward parabola, and y is equal to x is a straight line passing through origin with slope 1 unit. So, we need the area between these two curves. The point of intersection of these two will be y is equal to x and y is equal to x square. While solving, we will get the one point of intersection as 0, 0 and another one here 1, 1. So, we need the area between these two curves. So, the required area is nothing but area between x is equal to 0 to x is equal to 1, the area covered by straight line with x axis, which is x dx, from that minus integration of x is equal to 0 to 1 of the area covered by the parabola with the x axis. So, parabola curve is y is equal to x square dx. So, integration of x dx is nothing but x square by 2 minus this one is x cube by 3, and the limits are from 0 to 1. So, half minus 1 by 3, which is nothing but 1 by 6 square units. Third problem, find the area of the region lying in the first quadrant and bounded by y is equal to 4x square. Y is equal to 4x square is the upward parabola. X is equal to 0. X is equal to 0 is the y axis. This is x is equal to 0, this line. Y is equal to 1. Y is equal to 1 is a line parallel to x axis at a distance of 1 unit. And y is equal to 4 is a line parallel to x axis. So, y is equal to 1, y is equal to 4, and you need the area lying in the first quadrant. So, this is our required area. So, the required area, we can write it in the integral as integration of y is equal to 1 to y is equal to 4 with the y axis. So, the function is x is equal to f of y. So, it is nothing but root y divided by root 4 is 2 dy. So, 1 by 2 into integration of y to the power of half dy. Limits are from 1 to 4. So, which is nothing but outside half into y power half integration is y to the power of 3 by 2 into 2 by 3, and the limits are from 1 to 4. So, on simplification, we will get 4 to the power of 3 by 2 is 1 by 3 into 8 minus 1, which is nothing but 7 by 3 square units. Fourth problem, sketch the graph of y is equal to modulus of x plus 3. And evaluate integration of minus 6 to 0 mod x plus 3 dx. First, y is equal to mod x plus 3, modulus value is always positive. So, y is always positive. So, first one, y is always greater than or equal to 0. So, the graph is always above the x axis. Now, by the definition of modulus function, y is equal to positive x plus 3 for all the values of x plus 3 greater than or equal to 0, that is x is greater than or is equal to minus 3. So, y is equal to x plus 3 is one straight line, and y is equal to minus of x plus 3 for all the x values less than or equal to minus 3. So, now let us sketch the graph of these two lines separately. So, we will have the graph is for first one, y is equal to x plus 3 is a graph. So, just to sketch the graph, we need two points, x 0, y 3. So, x 0, y 3 is here, this is 0, 3, and when y is 0, x is minus 3. So, here minus 3. So, this is the first straight line. The straight line will be like this. This straight line is y is equal to x plus 3. And since y is always positive, it is modulus. We don't want the graph which is below the x axis. So, y is equal to x plus 3 is this graph. Next one, y is equal to minus of x plus 3. So, when x is 0, y value is minus 3. So, here one point. And when y is 0, x value is minus 3 again. So, this will be here. So, the second straight line is like this, but we don't, it will go like this. But we need the curve only above the x axis. So, this is our V shaped curve, modulus of x plus 3. Y is equal to mod x plus 3. Even we can do like this. Y is equal to mod x curve is like this. Y is equal to mod x plus 3 curve will be shifted towards left side at a unit of 3 units. At distance of 3 units. So, this is our required graph. Sketch the graph of y is equal to mod x plus 3 is, this is the graph y is equal to modulus of x plus 3. Now, this point is minus 3. So, y is equal to mod x plus 3 curve we got. Let us look at the second part. Evaluate integration of minus 6 to 0 modulus of x plus 3. So, the graph we will write it as minus 6 to, the turning point is at minus 3. So, minus 6 to minus 3, it is a positive one, x plus 3 the graph is. So, minus 6 to minus 3, our graph is less than values minus of x plus 3 dx, and for the next one it is from minus 3 to 0. So, the given integral is minus 6 to 0. So, the given integral can be written as minus 6 to minus 3, that is all the x values less than or equal to minus 3, it is negative of x plus 3 dx, and the values which are greater than minus 3, that is integration of minus 3 to, the question is only up to 0, it is positive of x plus 3 dx. Excuse me. So, this is modulus x plus 3 dx. Now, we will evaluate. So, this one is x square by 2 plus 3x, outside negative sign, limits are from minus 6 to minus 3, and second part here minus 3 is there, same thing, x square by 2 plus 3x, and the limits are from here minus 3 to 0. So, by applying the upper limits minus lower limits for both the integrals, we will get the answer as 9 square units.